a black man who was paralyzed, beaten by the police, and is now paralyzed, has received a $10 million settlement from the government. Let's put up his picture. Xavier Ingram, a father of four. Okay, this is what he looked like before his injuries, which took place in 2014. This black New Jersey man was left paralyzed after an encounter with police 8 years ago, has now reached a $10 million settlement with Camden County. It's the largest payout for police brutality there. Isn't that something, right? Now, you do realize who's paying this money? Well, taxpayers, the police department by extension. This is defunding the police, but they don't have any issues with bad cops defunding the police. They have issues when someone who's at a Black Lives Matter rally says, you know, defund the police, because we need to reprioritize policing budgets to actually prevent crime. So let me give you some background to this story of how this man was not only beaten, how the cops lied, and how they tried to basically set him up for a crime he never committed. Let's put his picture up again. Ingram's injuries, his federal lawsuit, and his settlement all stem from a 2014 run-in with three county metro police officers on a rainy night, June 12th, after they chased him on foot in connection to an outstanding warrant and driving infractions. While trying to elude police, Mr. Ingram, then 20 years of age, tripped and fell on South 7th Street. Okay, this was in the city's Bergen Square neighborhood. According to his lawsuit, that is when Officer Jeremy Merck allegedly stepped on and broke Ingram's neck, leaving him completely paralyzed in that moment. Ingram's lawsuit also claims the officers violated their emergency medical training by observing his state, yet still forcefully moving him and failing to stabilize his spine. They were still trying to torture him. After Ingram, let's put his picture up again. After Ingram went to the hospital, it was reported that there were injuries to multiple parts of his cervical spine caused by the assault. But the Camden County prosecutors said these injuries were there because he slipped and fell on a wet road. So that was the lie they were going with at first. Let's put up a picture of the cops who were involved. I'm giving you the full narrative here. Those are the cops, all right? They were involved in the assault. Let's go from left to right. Jeremy Merck, Antonio Ganata, and Nicholas Merchiafava. Those are the cops, okay? Antonio and Nicholas were both only 6 months out of the police academy. Merck is no longer with the police force, but the other two cops are still county cops. Once in custody and hospitalized, the police alleged that Mr. Ingram, the victim, was in possession of heroin and a handgun. They said, he's the trifecta here. He ran from the police, he had heroin and he had a gun. They wanted this case open and shut. Oh, you gotta ignore the fact that we paralyzed him. I mean, this is a bad guy. We saved lives that night. He had a gun and heroin and was running from the police. They did this because they wanted their actions to be excused. There's more. But all the criminal charges against Ingram were actually dropped after the attorney introduced evidence during this year's trial, suggesting the cops planted it all. After the arrest, the Camden County Police noted this statement from the then police chief. All right, it says the arresting officers displayed composure throughout the incident and had the presence of mind to immediately render aid and summon medical assistance. Lies, all lies. Put up a picture of the chief. This is then police chief John Scott Thompson. All right. The settlement is now waiting to be approved by the US District Chief Judge who presided over the civil case, but the county officials are not happy about it. Camden County officials are reportedly in complete disagreement over the settlement. But the spokesperson Dan Kishin, insisting that the insurance carrier is making a business decision and forcing the hand of Camden County. We will be settling the case with Mr. Ingram, but we do not believe this is the right decision, said the spokesperson. The county maintains no wrongdoing took place. It is not liable for any of the actions and circumstances. Isn't that something? Literally, you have a prosecutor, a judge, you have an insurance company, you have a community, and you have a victim who says, they say one thing, this is what happened. This is what, and some of these individuals started on the other side of the narrative, believing the cops were right. They have decided to change their mind now based on evidence presented. But the city, oh no, we did nothing wrong here. And this is why people don't like you, all right? Because of your inability to actually hold individuals accountable that are within the industry of policing. But you want to be in charge of holding everybody else accountable. You want to be the law while at the same time being in violation of the law. You want to hold people accountable while at the same time having no accountability for your own actions. People don't like that. $10 million has been approved. $10 million will be awarded. I don't give a damn what Camden County says. Now, this is defunding the police. So if you want to keep more money in your county, if you want to make sure that taxpayers don't pay a bigger bill, make sure you don't have corrupt ass cops. That's how you do that. Because this is not the only case they've had to pay out. And how does it pass on to the taxpayer when the insurance company pays the money? Because the premium that will be set in the month of January 2023 will be higher. And that money will be passed on to the taxpayers of Camden County because you got corrupt ass cops. Alonzo, thoughts here?
Well, the first thing is when it comes to the money, take it out of the policeman's pension fund.
There you go.
And watch how quick the good cops turn over to bad cops. When you're like, oh, your pension fund just lost $10 million. You know, that's one thing. Another thing, this is not a big settlement. This man's paralyzed for the rest of his life. He's quadriplegic and requires 24-hour care. That costs a lot of money. And the odds are pretty good he doesn't have any kind of health insurance that's paying that. So this $10 million isn't a windfall. This $10 million will be spent over the course of his life to keep him alive. And just think of the difference in quality of life going from a 20-year-old ordinary guy, whatever, to being a quadriplegic forever. I mean, sure. So they make it sound like a lot of money. This ain't a lot of money for the hell that he's gone through. Now, you know how we know he didn't have a gun? They didn't kill him. That's simple. Right.
Exactly.
They didn't kill him. If he had a gun, they'd have killed him. And we know that. We've seen enough people killed without a gun. If you're coming out of a liquor store and you have a gun and the cops are there, you are dead. Okay. There's no other, you know, outcome for that. So we know he didn't have a gun. And like you said, this is another case where defending, not defunding, defending the police destroys your credibility as a city government, as a police department, or whatever else. This is exactly why people don't like police, why people don't trust police. You say people of color don't trust, don't like, can't stand the police. This is why, because three cops beat a man into paralysis, planted evidence on him, and they're not in jail. They're not in jail. Okay. The city just made a deal, pay it off, and let them go. And this is one of those, and we've seen these before, right? They just become cops in the next town over, or the next county over, or whatever. They get hired again and continue their career. It's horrific. And the worst part of this story is again, because here it is, it happened again. And it will happen again.
Right. And no criminal charges against the cops. Yep. Two of them are able to work in that same county. One resigned, and you're right, is free to go somewhere else now.